Good morning, this is John Donahue, and you're listening to Heaven Bound.
I see a city. I see my home. I see my blessed.
Good morning again, friends, and welcome one more time to Heaven Bound. I am Doug Benedict, and thankfully, Mr. Bo Bailey has returned because I have murdered the directions for way too many times. So I've not quite gotten fired, but under probation, and he is my supervisor. Well, on behalf of the good folks here at Calvary Bible Church, we would like to extend an invitation and, most importantly, say thank you for spending 34 years now
almost
of the church, and the radio program has been going for
even
from
longer.
Preacher's been on the radio for a lot longer than that, but yeah, from Calvary Bible Church has been, well, I guess 30 years. We'll just call it 30 just because we don't know any better.
Yeah.
So we would like to, again, invite you to come out. What are our times?
We start this morning with a coffee hour at 9 o'clock, which is only a half hour long, not an hour. And at 9:30, we have our Sunday school hour, which is an hour. Then our morning service, a regular Sunday morning service, starts at 10:30. And then we also have an evening service this Sunday, which will be at 6 p.m.
Then midweek, we have prayer meeting, and that starts at 7 o'clock. Like I said, I'm so glad you're back. Last week, I couldn't even tell what times they were. Thank you, good old allergies. Have my brain packed up and moved away somewhere. If for some reason you're not able to attend, please give us a call. Our phone number is 315-348-6271, or send us an email at cbclewiscounty.com. That's our web address.
That's our web address, yeah.
Maybe I should let you do this. What's our email?
Email address is cbclewiscounty@gmail.com. Our current web address is cbclewiscounty. That's our email address.
Now it's rubbing off. So since I got that part right, I'll take that. The website is cbclewiscounty.com. He gave you the email address. Feel free and give us a shout. If you would like to come, unable to make it, for whatever reason, we can try to coordinate and arrange for someone to come out and pick you up. You know, we don't want to turn away anyone. Even if you're a ways away, we can probably figure something out and get you here. If for some reason you're still not able to come, you're bedridden, whatever, we do broadcast live on the web, and those addresses are
cbclewiscounty.com.
I set you up on that.
Yes,
one.
Yes, you did.
We're also on livestream.com, and that lot of programs have apps built right in for live stream. Search for Calvary Bible Church, Greg, and you will find us. We don't actually have a dedicated web address there. We do have a real special event coming up starting July 17th.
Yes, it'll be our celebration of our 34 years being established as a church here in Gregg, New York. It does start, we do have Anniversary Sunday, but just before Anniversary Sunday on July 17th through the 20th, we will have Mr. Morris Anderson with us. He does come from Manna Ministries. He is a very wonderful speaker. He is a sportsman. He does a lot of sportsmen's banquets. He will be here for special meetings on those nights. We're also working on some other possible ideas that go into that weekend as well. And then on the 20th, which is Sunday, we have our anniversary service, which will start at 10 a.m. that morning because we do have some additional festivities on Anniversary Sunday. And if you want to know what those festivities are, you'll have to show up to find out. If you want to know how to get here, I'm going to give the directions that Doug apparently has not been able to get right. If you go to Google Maps, there you go. There are the directions. If you turn off of Route 12 onto the Burdick's Crossing Road by the Valley Brook Drive-In, Go all the way to the end of the road. At the stop sign, take a left onto the Gregg Road. You'll go up the hill just about a quarter of a mile and turn your first right, which is Sweeney Road. We're about 200 yards up the road on the right-hand side of the road. Plenty of parking. We welcome you with open arms.
Absolutely. And definitely please put on your calendar. Even if you're away and you're listening on the internet and you have been moved away for a while, if you used to attend the church, we would love to see you again. And what better time to come back than on our 34th anniversary of the church. Now, I do have a really, really important question. What are you afraid of?
What am I afraid of?
Yes.
I'm afraid of how I'm going to die.
That's a good fear. I think I kind of have Charlie Brown's fear. What is it, that anaphilacobia, fear of everything?
Fear of everything.
But no, mostly creatures that move without legs, namely snakes. I know there's a gentleman in church
that
shares that with me. But preacher is going to come today and kind of address some of the fears. A lot of people fear, like Mr. Bailey said, of how they're going to die, what comes after death, what have you. You know, just stuff that comes around death is just a huge unknown. And preacher is going to come calm some of those fears and just really help you out. And hopefully you will be willing to listen and put yourself in those shoes so that you can be ready to die. As we get ready for preacher to come, turn in your Bibles to Joshua chapter 1. And again, let's listen to preacher's favorite group, Gold City, and they're going to do a song that really ties right in with today's message, Be Not Afraid.
Well, the waves were tossing and the boat was rocking as the storm came rolling in. The disciples feared that the end was near as they stood in the rain and the wind. Then the rain fell harder, lightning struck the water. Everybody trembled on board. There was no chance to be saved from the watery grave until they heard the voice of the Lord.
Be not afraid.
Be not afraid. It is I, said the Master, walking on the waves of the stormy sea.
Be not afraid.
Be not afraid. It is I, said the Master, a little faith is all that you need. I will calm the storm if you believe.
When your hope is battered and your dreams are shattered and your faith is sinking fast, when the storms of life bring its fear and strife and you feel like your strength won't last,
though you may feel shaken, you are not forsaken.
God has got it in control, for the howling winds are no match for him when he whispers peace to your soul.
Be not afraid.
Be not afraid. It is I, said the Master, walking on the waves of the stormy sea.
Be not afraid.
Be not afraid, it is I, said the Master, a little faith is all that you need. I will calm the storm if you believe.
Be not afraid.
Be not afraid, it is I, said the Master, walking on the waves of the stormy sea.
Be not afraid.
Be not afraid, it is I, said the Master, a little faith is all that you need. I will calm the storm if you storm if you believe. I will calm the storm if you believe.
And another good morning, friends. Great to be with you one more time. We're in Joshua this morning. Chapter 1. Israel is now gotten to the edge of the promised land. 40 years before, they had gotten to the edge of the promised land, and they had sent spies in. In Numbers chapter 14, they had sent in 12 spies at Kadesh Barnea, and Israel was encamped there. The 12 spies went in to spy out the land of Canaan, and they came back. 10 spies Actually, all 12 spies agreed that it was a land flowing with milk and honey, that it was a fabulous land. But 10 of the spies said we were as grasshoppers in their sight, and there is absolutely no way that we can conquer the promised land. Two spies, Joshua and Caleb, gave the minority report and said, yes, it is true. We are as grasshoppers in their sight, but with God, we are able. All that night, 40 years earlier, the people cried, they grumbled, they complained, and said, we're going to get ourselves killed. We cannot take the land. So God said to Moses, all right, you tell them that they're not going in and that they're going to wander for 40 years in the wilderness. Well, after Moses told them that, then they all began to say, we're able, we can take the promised land, we're able to do it. Oh, yeah, we believe God. Moses said, you can't and you won't. Even if you try to go up, you're going to be defeated. So they tried to go up anyway, and they were defeated by the Canaanites, and for 40 years, they wandered around basically in a big circle in the wilderness. God provided for them, but everybody that was 20 years or 21 years of age and up died. All of them died. Their carcasses dropped in the wilderness. So now a whole new generation has gotten to the edge of the promised land. Joshua and Caleb, the only two spies that said they were able, that Israel could take it, have survived the 40 years. And they are now getting ready to go in. Moses, the leader of Israel, has died. Joshua has been elected, or God put him in control. Joshua is now the new leader of Israel. They are now ready to go into the promised land. After 40 years of wandering in a big circle around and around, they are now ready to go into the promised land. And the Lord says to Joshua in Joshua chapter 1, he says, be strong and of a good courage. For unto this people shalt thou divide for an inheritance the land which I swear unto their fathers to give them. Only be strong and very courageous, that thou mayest observe to do according to all the law which Moses, my servant, commanded thee. Turn not from it to the right hand or to the left, that thou mayest prosper whithersoever thou goest. This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth. Then again in verse 9, have not I commanded thee, be strong and of a good courage, be not afraid, neither be thou dismayed, for the Lord thy God is with thee whithersoever thou goest. That little phrase, be not afraid, there, somebody has added up, and I'm taking their word for it. Maybe I shouldn't, but I read this the other day. There are 365 be not afraids in the Bible. There's one for every day. Probably that's probably so, but be not afraid. Here Joshua's at the edge of the promised land, and boy, what a task is before him. They have to drive out the Canaanites from the land, as God said. They have to observe everything that God said to Moses. God says to Joshua, be strong and of a good courage, neither be afraid. There are so many phobias in the world. You go on the internet and type into your search engine, list the phobias, you'll find hundreds of them. Things that people, they're afraid of spiders, they're afraid of snakes, they're afraid of holes in the wall, they're afraid of chairs, they're afraid of the outdoors, they're afraid of the indoors. I mean, it's just a list of things that people are afraid of. But there are some things that most people really do fear. One of those, of course, is fear of the unknown. We don't know about tomorrow. We live in a very, very, very turbulent world. We live in a world where there's nothing that's for sure. We don't know for sure. There's a song, many things about tomorrow I don't seem to understand. And that's true. We simply, people say, well, I like to know, and many people go to these palm readers, tea leaf readers. They check their daily horoscope. They look at what Gene Dixon has to say or Nostradamus has to say. And they run their lives by the, let's see, astrology. Yeah, they're astrologists, not astronomists, but an astrologist, somebody who figures out their destiny by the stars. Because they want to know what's going to happen because people have a fear of the unknown. Well, what if I go broke? What if I get sick? What if somebody I know gets sick and dies? What if I lose my house? What if I lose my car? What if I don't have enough to eat? And people are fearful about the unknown. And to some extent, I suppose everybody be that, but God said to Joshua, be not afraid. Be of a good courage. Be of good courage. Have I not commanded thee? Be of a good courage. Be strong. Good courage. Don't be afraid. Because you see, folks, I know somebody who does know about what's going to happen in the future. And that's God. And God has promised this in Matthew chapter 6 and verse 33. He said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these other things shall be added unto you. Seek first the kingdom of God. See, we don't have to worry about food. We don't have to worry about raiment. We don't have to worry about a house. God will take care of that for us. If we seek first the kingdom of God, and really that's what God said to Joshua. He said to him that be strong and of a good courage. Have I not commanded thee? Didn't I tell you, be not afraid, neither be thou dismayed. Now notice, for the Lord thy God is with thee whithersoever thou goest. By its very term, God, there can't be a lot of gods. When we say God, we are denoting one supreme being. We're saying that there is one person who is in control of everything. Be not dismayed. For, he said, I am with thee whithersoever thou goest. For the Lord thy God, God, is with thee. You say, preacher, do you worry about running out of money? Not normally. Because over the last... See, my wife and I have been married a long time this year. And over that long period of time, you say, do you know how long you've been married? Absolutely, I do. Now, over that amount of time, I have seen God time and time again provide for my need. God said he would provide my need. Now, he doesn't always provide what I want, but he does provide what I need. I don't have to worry about tomorrow. Usually, I really don't think that much even about it. I just live from day to day. God promised that he would take care of me. People are fearful of the unknown because they don't know God. If they knew God, friend, if you knew God, there is a song that we sing. I'm trying to remember exactly how it goes. Oh, it is well with my soul. Though Satan should buffet, though trials should come, let this blessed assurance control that Christ has to regard it my helpless estate and shed his own blood for my soul. Let this calm assurance that God is in control. People are fearful of the unknown. They're fearful about tomorrow because they do not know the one who controls tomorrow. You say, preacher, do you ever think about getting sick? Well, sometimes it crosses my mind. But I know that in the end, in the final, that God knows. And that leads me to the second thing. People are not only fearful of the unknown, but here is one from Hebrews chapter 2. People are fearful of dying. Songwriter put it, are you fearful at the thought of dying? Tell it to Jesus. Most people all their lives are fearful about dying. Now, they may not think about it when they're a kid, and they may not think about it when they're a teenager. They may not think about it as a young adult, or perhaps even as a later young adult, or maybe early middle age. But by the time they begin to get toward the latter stages of middle age, in the early stages of old age, people begin to think about dying. And it's usually not a very pleasant thought. I'm going to die. My friend, you're going to die. Now, you may be a young person. You say, well, I'm not going to die this year. And I mean, nobody knows. The doctor told me the other day, I said to him, well, I feel so good. I may drop over dead with a heart attack tomorrow. He said, well, I don't think you will. And that was on Friday, and I lived through Saturday, so I don't guess I did. But it's like many people are fearful. What's going to happen to me when I die? Somebody asked John Wayne, that big, tough guy. They asked him, are you afraid of dying? And he answered that. He said, of course I am. He says, because I don't know what's on the other side. People say, well, I really don't know what's on this. I can tell you this. I can tell you. The Bible says in Hebrews 9:27, it's appointed unto men once to die. After this is the judgment. My friend, you're going to die. And secondly, you're going to stand before God. You will stand before God. And perhaps that is what people are so fearful of, standing before God. Now, they may not want to admit it. They may not want to admit that there's a God, but deep down inside, look, even atheists, those guys are, never mind. Those guys, for people who are so, who say there is no God, they sure do hate and revile and antagonistic toward those of us who do believe God. If you don't believe there's a God, and don't think there's a God, and say there is no God, leave me alone. Go your merry way. But the problem with those guys is that deep down inside, when nobody else is around, and they don't think anybody else is watching or listening, they have this gnawing, seeking suspicion. They have a gnawing suspicion that maybe there is a God, and they're going to have to stand before him. The Bible says there is a God, that people are going to stand before him. And people are fearful at the thought of having to stand before God. Well, I'd be fearful too if I didn't know God. People are fearful at the thought, I'm going to die, and what's going to happen to me? And I know that there are people who have hallucinations, and I'm going to say this, there's a real difference between hallucinations and actually being in heaven. People have hallucinations in a near state of death in which they see a beautiful bright light. And I remind you that Satan is the angel of light. Now look, people are fearful at the thought of dying. Are you? Are you fearful of having to stand before God? I don't believe there is a God. Yeah, but when you're by yourself all alone, you've got this sneaking suspicion that maybe there is a God. Why would you rail against people so badly if you didn't think there was a God? And besides, while I'm on that issue, a person who says they're an atheist, really what they're saying is that they know everything about everything. And so they're saying that I know there is no God because I know everything about everything. And there's nobody in this world that knows all that. And so, friend, in that place where you know nothing about, God exists. You're going to stand before him. People are fearful. We live in a fearful age. People pop pills nonstop, trying to get past their phobias. People pop pills to relieve the anxiety. They're trying to get by it. People get drunk, smashed out of their minds so they don't have to face all the problems that they have in life. The only problem is that sooner or later they're going to wake up again. People are fearful. God said to Joshua, be strong and of a good courage. Neither be thou afraid nor be dismayed, for the Lord thy God is with thee whithersoever thou goest. Friend, may I ask you that question? What are you fearful of? You fearful at the thought of dying? Most people who do not know God are fearful of dying because they do not, as John Wayne said, know what's on the other side. Are you fearful about what may happen? Maybe the economy will crash. What are we going to do with the economy crisis, preacher? Trust God. What are we going to do if the consumer price index shoots up and inflation becomes such that they can't keep prices because the prices are changing so rapidly? Oh, that would never happen here. Well, they didn't think it would happen in Argentina or Brazil, but it did. Preacher, what's going to happen if we don't have enough to eat? Preacher, what's going to happen if I get cancer, if I have heart disease and I may die? Preacher, what am I going to do? God said to Joshua, be strong and have a good courage. Neither be thou afraid nor dismayed. My friend, God will take care of you. I love that song. He will take care of you through every day or all the way. He will take care of you. God will take care of you. He's my heavenly Father. He knows exactly what I need. He seldom shows up early, but he never shows up late. He is, as God says, as Jesus said, when you pray, say, our Father. Paul says, we cry, Abba, Father. He is our Father. He knows what I need, just when I need it, and he will provide it. And my friend, I want you to know that God will do the same for you. God loves you. He sent his only begotten Son to die for you. Jesus paid the price so that God could be your Father, so that you could be adopted into the family of God. What are you fearful of? Bible says this, that hell, the lake of fire, will be populated by the fearful. People who are afraid. Now, those people are people who would say, well, I'm afraid of what mama or daddy would think if I got saved. Maybe you're listening today. Maybe you're fearful of other people. Well, if I got saved and started coming to church, my friends would all laugh at me. Friend, they're not going to be, and you're not going to be laughing when you stand before God. Fearful. Fearful of what others may say. Fearful of what others may think. Fearful about the unknown. Fearful at the thought of dying. Fearful at the thought of standing before God. How about you, friend? What about it? What are you afraid of today? What is it? What is it? What is it? He's waiting. Jesus is waiting. He was there all the time, waiting patiently in line. He was there all the time. Jesus is tenderly calling today. Sinner, oh sinner, come home. He wants you to come today, friend. He'll be your Father. The Bible says this, Jesus will be your elder brother. Boy, to have an older brother that's looking out for you, to have a father that's looking out for you. Say, do you ever worry, preacher? Oh, once in a while. But I've got a father who cares, and I've got an elder brother who cares, and who loves me and cares for me. And my friend, he'll do the same for you. But you have to accept that. You have to believe that. You have to trust that. Say, what is that, preacher? Well, trust that, one, you're a sinner. And you are. Put it down. Mark it down. You're a sinner. Secondly, that Jesus paid your sin debt. Now, either Jesus paid it or, friend, you're going to pay it. Why not let Jesus? Call upon him today. Lord, I realize I'm a sinner, but I believe you love me. And the best way I know how, I trust Jesus as my Savior. Friend, invite him to come into your heart. He'll take away that fear. Trust him today. Call upon him today, because tomorrow just might be too late.
Friend, there are so many things in this life to be afraid of, whether they're nonsense things or they're justifiable. Wouldn't you like to eliminate one of those fears and not have to worry about what happens after you die? If you would give us a call at 315-348-6271 or send us an email at cbclewiscounty@gmail.com, we would love to talk to you and show you how you can be saved and not have to worry about what comes after death. Thank you again for spending this half hour with us. Lord willing, we will catch you again next week on Heaven Bound.